If you want to display posts, pages, and other content in many different ways on your website, you'll love this new feature in Thrive Architect. Meet the easiest to use, most flexible, and most customizable post gallery feature for WordPress. With our new post list element and templates, you can create beautiful post lists, grids, and masonry layouts to display your blog posts, pages, or custom post types. And in this video, we'll have a closer look. Hello, I'm Shane Relach from Thrive Themes, and what's new in our post list element is that apart from being fully customizable, it now also comes with dozens of pre-designed templates to choose from. Now, in the beginning of the video, I made some bold claims, and let me back those up. So I said it's the easiest to use, the most flexible, and the most customizable. Let me show you how. First of all, it is super easy to use because all you do is, in Thrive Architect, you drop the post list element onto your page and you get instant access to dozens of templates. You just choose one, load it, and there you go. Second, it's super flexible because each template allows you to display your content in various ways and with instantly customizable columns. And everything is super mobile responsive and looks great on any screen size. It is also flexible because we have different templates suited for all kinds of different purposes. We have templates that can show off your posts in a large and glorious manner. We have compact designed templates so you can show off a lot of content without taking up a lot of screen space. And we have everything in between. And the further point for flexibility is that we have different templates that work with large featured images, small featured images, or no featured images at all. So no matter how you design your content, no matter what you want your page to look like, we've got a template to match your style. So you've got all these templates to choose from, but that's not where it ends. And this is where the third factor comes in. These post lists are super customizable. Customization is quick and easy because we are using the group editing technology from Thrive Architect in our post list element. For example, if I want to edit the look of this post list right here, I select it and I click on Edit Design. And that puts me into edit mode for just this list. And here I can make changes. And if I make a change, so let's say I want to change something about the text here, I want to make it a bit larger and I don't want it to be all caps. As you can see, the change I make to one text element applies to all of the text elements for everything in the grid. So I don't have to go and apply the same change several times. And the same goes for other changes as well. So I can click this button here and I can choose a different color for my button. And in just a few clicks, I've changed the look of all the buttons in the grid. But more than that, everything you see here is fully drag and drop editable. Every element can be dragged and dropped into place. You can remove elements you don't want, and you can even add new elements, including dynamic content elements. So when I'm in edit mode for the list and I open the elements drawer, we can see that we have article components, and these are all dynamic components. So here I can add things like author name, post content, post title, and so on, which will be dynamically populated with the current post's title, image, author, and so on. For example, maybe I want to add an author image here, which can be really good for multi-author blogs. And I'll resize this, make it a lot smaller, of course, maybe center align it, and maybe make it overlap this other image here. And let's also add a little border. And that is how quickly we can go from one of the templates to a customized version of our own. Here's the thing. If you look at all the templates that come with the post list element, every single one of those templates can be built from scratch using the tools available to you in Thrive Architect. Your imagination is the only limit here. And finally, our post list is super customizable thanks to the advanced targeting rules. So if I choose the post list, I can go into filter posts to decide what is shown here and in what order. I can choose to display posts or pages or products or whatever other custom post types I have on the site. And then I can start creating display rules. For example, I can say I want to show posts of a specific category, and I can even add further conditions. So I can say I want posts from this category, but only if they're not part of a specific tag. And we can add in multiple rules like this to exactly refine what should show in a post list. Then I can sort them by date or by comment count or by authors or titles. I can sort them ascending or descending, and I can choose how many posts should be shown in the list. So whatever content you want to show in whatever order and whatever context, with these targeting rules, you can make it happen. So that's a look at what you can do with the post list element. To make this a bit more practical, let's have a look at a couple of scenarios of how you might want to use these on a conversion focused website. So scenario number one, let's say I'm working on my homepage, and right now I have basically the top and bottom part of my homepage. I have a call to action at the top, call to action at the bottom, and I want the middle part of my page. And one thing I might want to show here is blog posts. So I can write something like, check out my latest posts, and then add a post list element. Here, I'll choose this template here, which is very image focused, since this is a photography website in this example. That makes a lot of sense. And right away, I can say, okay, let's show maybe 9 of my latest posts. So I'll change this to 9, save, and here we go. This completes my simple homepage. I now have a title, call to action, some content, and then another call to action at the bottom. But with targeting rules and different templates, we have many other options as well. So instead of just showing a list of latest posts, here's what I could do. I could say, check out my latest tutorials, and let's choose a different template. And I want to show only 4 of them. And I'll edit the design and just make this picture a little bit larger here. Because this is a photography-based website, I want to emphasize my picture a bit. And in the filter here, we want to add posts from a specific category, which is photography tutorials. So now I have a selection of posts that are all on a specific topic, and I can go ahead and duplicate this. And let's say we have reviews. Then I go in here, filter the posts, and change this from tutorials to reviews. And in this way, with a couple of duplications and a little bit of editing, we can have a homepage which gives people a good overview over different topics covered on the website, and is basically more pleasing and easier to engage with than just a list of posts. Then let's have a look at one more scenario. Let's say I have a webinar funnel in my business where people sign up for a webinar, and when they do, I send them to a thank you page that basically confirms, yes, you've been signed up to the webinar. Now here's an important conversion principle. We never want to leave a visitor just hanging. We don't want to say, okay, you've signed up, nothing else to do. Instead, if I have here my confirmation message that confirms they've been signed up, maybe there's some reminder of the date and time of the webinar, and then I can say, hey, in the meantime, while you wait for the webinar to start, check out this post on a related topic. So once again, let's grab the post list element, drop it in here. And this time I want to choose a template that really showcases a post in a large way. And I quite like this one here. Now I'm going to filter this to show just one post, and I can handpick that post. So I can choose a very specific post that I think is going to be most interesting and most engaging to people who signed up to this webinar. So let's choose this one. And then let's also tweak the design a little bit. Let's start by choosing this content box, changing the color. So I could choose a color here that matches the template I'm using quite easily. And then I definitely want this title to be bigger because I've chosen to show only one post. Let's go in here and really bring this title out, make it bold. And maybe we can also go in here and change the height here to just emphasize this picture further. So now we have one post really spectacularly showcased as a strong call to action. Hey, you've signed up for the webinar, now go check out this post. So these are just some of the examples of what you can do with our super easy, super flexible, and super customizable post lists for WordPress. Check out the Thrive Architect plugin for WordPress to get access to this. If you're already a customer, update to the latest version and you'll get access to all these templates and features right away. And let us know what kinds of templates you would like to see in the future by leaving a comment below.